Verse 10 says, "Remove thy stroke away from me. I am consumed by the blow of thine hand." So David kept quiet before God, took that time to just meditate upon things. He sought the Lord immediately, realized his vanity, recognized his hope was only in Christ. And in verse 10, he received correction. He says, "Remove thy stroke away from me. I am consumed by the blow of thine hand." I understand, God. I understand who I am. You've shown me who I am. You've made me to know the error of my ways. And he remained humble through it. And then it ends in verse 11. He says, "When thou with rebukes dost correct man for iniquity, thou makest his beauty to consume away like a moth. Surely every man is vanity, Selah." And there's the pause. He was corrected. He was set right by the rebukes that came upon him. Whenever we're rebuked and exposed by the word of God, it's just like a moth-eating garment. God just shows us all the holes in us. He picks away at what would be a complete piece of cloth and puts these holes in it, just like a moth tearing away at fabrics. Our beauty falls away. Our carnality is consumed. We're revealed as what we are, and that's just vain and empty. We got holes in us. We got problems. And yet when we set ourselves to understand that about ourselves, all that does is bring more light to Christ, which died for us and gave himself, and he's our hope. It reveals to us that while we have all these problems, glory to God, there's a God in heaven that loved us anyways, enough to come down here and repair the breach. He took a rotten, tattered garment that was our good works, because all of us at a time thought we could earn heaven. We thought whether we were an unbeliever or whether we were a religious person that we could get there on our own. Tattered garments before God. Filthy rags, the Bible says, is our works before him. He took that moth-eaten, rotten piece of fabric and he made it fresh. He made it new. He revived it. And that's where our hope lies. That's what David is coming to that conclusion. But it's not a problem that we see faults in us. It's not an issue that when we meditate upon God's word, sometimes we're just like, I broke that, I did that, I sinned. And you feel like God's just highlighting all the problems in your life. Do you know what that's supposed to do? Well, if you're a vain and empty vessel, you're just someone that is fit for God to fill. You got nothing left. I'm vain. I'm empty. There's nothing to me. I have nothing to offer a righteous God. But he could take you, empty and lacking as you are, and fill you with whatever he chooses. We need to understand that we are needing before we can have our need provided for. We need to understand that we're sinners before we can be saved by the salvation that he offers. We need to understand that we are vain before we can be given purpose by the living God. It's good to be an empty vessel because then you can be filled. It's good to be a torn up, stinky, shredded garment because he can clean it and patch it up. Right? It's good to have and have revealed to you that you've got issues and problems because that's the humble mentality. The proud person thinks that they have no need of anything, thinks that they have no lack, thinks that they've got it together. God wants to take the needy and do something with them. And I love how David says it. He's like, "My hope is in thee." He said, "I was able to keep my mouth because thou didst it." You've done it all.